What's going on, guys? It's Rachel here from Makers Gonna Learn, and today I'm gonna be teaching you all how to iron on towels. This video is highly requested, and I hope that you learn something from it and enjoy it. I know it might seem hard to iron on towels, but it's really super easy. And with these tricks that I'm giving you today, you'll be able to iron on towels like a pro. For this video, we'll be using our Cricut Maker, the mini EasyPress that's 6x7, and two files from our home collection in Makers Gonna Learn. If you are not already a member of makersgonnalearn.com, it is an exclusive die cutting community that's perfect if you have a Cricut Maker, a Brother Scan and Cut, a Silhouette Cameo, anything like that. You will love the membership. It has over 700 cut files like the ones we're using today, and more are added every single month. Plus, we also have fonts. We have over 80 fonts right now, and more fonts are added every quarter for yearly members. It's such a great community, and you need to go check it out. To start off today's video, we're going to jump over here into Cricut Design Space. And if you all want to know how to download SVGs or PNGs to your iPad or your laptop, head over to the channel and check out some of Tanner's great videos about how to do that. Today, we're working with two adorable files from our home collection in Makers Gonna Learn, Whisk Me Away and Be Grateful. And today, of course, we're making kitchen towels. So this really fits with the cute, quirky kitchen theme. But the most important thing to do once we have our images in Design Space is to size our towels. So here are the towels we're using today. They're little small hand towels, and these are perfect to hang on the stove, you know, to lay out and be decorative. These are not, you know, meant to be used a ton in the kitchen when washing dishes and things like that. These are going to be adorable little display towels. So here we have a measuring tape, and we're just going to measure and see how long we'd like it to be. And it's a good tip to go ahead and fold your towels how you will be displaying them in your home as you size them, so that way you know they will fit well on the towel that you have folded. So it looks like we're going to do about 4 inches, and it can be pretty high, as up to 7 inches high. So we're gonna go over here into Design Space, and our width is 4 inches and our height is 4.3 inches. That is a great place to be. So we're gonna go ahead and click Make It. And this is an iron-on project, so we want to be sure to turn mirror on. The reason for that is that iron-on comes with its own built-in transfer paper. We love that it comes with its own transfer paper, so we don't have to add any or buy any ourselves. And that is why you will pay a little more for iron-on. And you always want to apply iron-on onto your mat shiny side down, which is transfer paper side down, which is the reason you need to mirror all of your images. Now we're just gonna hit continue and select iron-on. And now we're gonna head over to the machine and load our mat. And we're just gonna take our mat, and we've already applied white iron-on to the mat. White iron-on is one of our favorites, and we love using it for all different kinds of projects. So now all you have to do is load it into the machine and press that flashing Cricut button. One good thing to do while your Cricut is cutting is come over to your EasyPress and check and see what temperature it should be set to. Thanks to Makers Gonna Learn, we have a wonderful Cricut printable guide filled with so many things that you'll want to see, from terminology glossaries to blade cutting charts to finding out what mat you need to use with what project. We even have cheat sheets for using different types of things like iron-on and vinyl. And here in the back, we will find an awesome EasyPress temperature chart. And these towels are 100% cotton. So for everyday iron-on like we're using, it says to set it to 315 degrees and to peel off warm. So we're just gonna turn our EasyPress on, and it's already set to 315 degrees from our previous project. So now while your Cricut is cutting, just let your EasyPress heat up. Once the action is complete, simply unload the mat and get to weeding. Before you get to weeding, be sure to take a craft knife like this Cricut True Control knife and cut out all of your excess iron-on, because you want to save it. Once you've cut all your excess iron-on off, take your Cricut weeding tool of choice and get going. Once everything is weeded, simply peel your designs up from your mat. Now we're going to lay our towel down onto our mini EasyPress mat. We love these EasyPress mats. They do an amazing job at transferring the heat back up into your project, and they ensure a perfect project every time. Once your EasyPress is preheated, apply it down onto your towel for just a few seconds. Now, position your iron-on where you'd like it to go, and apply your EasyPress down, and press the timer. Be sure to apply firm pressure onto projects like this. Once you're finished heating this towel, set it to the side before removing your transfer paper and heat your other towel. Once you're finished with your second towel, while the first towel is still warm, slowly peel off your transfer paper. And do the same with your second towel. What did you all think of our cute little towels? I love the way they turned out, and I hope that you all learned a lot in this video and that now you're confident to iron on your towels. If you want to see where we got these two files that we used in this video, plus over 700 more and fonts, please check out the first link in the description below, and you can join makersgonnalearn.com. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Bye.